Your guidance has been exemplary, and we want to thank you. On behalf of the Avon School Board of Trustees, I want to emphasize that the board members are focused on the health and the safety of our students and staff. We are working side by side with the administration team, our trusted health partners, and the Indiana Department of Education to ensure there is minimal further exposure to our students and staff, and continue receiving educational services despite our unique situation. Thank you for joining us. We appreciate your support.
Now, Dr. Box, our state health commissioner, will come forward.
Good afternoon, everyone. I want to thank Dr. Stopervich and Superintendent Horniman for including me in this press conference today. I wanted to take a minute to update you, since it's been since the end of last week that I was updating you on where we were. We had one case as of the end of last week and have added three additional cases since that time. You know, the original case was a Marion County individual that had contact in Boston out there with individuals who became ill from COVID-19. Our case here in Hendricks County has a similar contact, and that individual is able to isolate at home. We've had a second case in Hendricks County, and this is the only one that we have that's not an adult, and that individual is also isolating at home. And our third case is in northern Indiana in Noble County. That individual is hospitalized in Noble County there, but stable. All of our individuals are stable at this time. We have tested 30 individuals and have only these four positives. Every other test has been negative. We are continuing to monitor individuals that are considered to be at higher risk, and they are on home quarantine, and that is going very well. We continued to work over the weekend when we found out that we had a youth that had tested positive, and we're very happy to engage with Dr. Stopervich and with the superintendent and the school board here, along with their principals here. And we had a lot of very good discussions, and I think that they have come to what they think, out of an abundance of caution, is the best way to make sure that they are protecting all of the youth here in Avon Community Schools. I will say that they are exceeding even that which the CDC might recommend that they have to do. Again, just trying to make sure that we are keeping the health of the students here and the safety at the utmost of every decision that is made. I want to say this is very clear. This is not a spring break where everybody runs out and goes to the mall, goes to the movies, goes to the theater, goes to, you know, whatever museum. We really need, if we're going to have this work, to have these individuals social distance, which means that you go home and you read books, or you play games with your family, or you do your video games, or whatever those activities are that you can do at home, rather than being out in public, because the point of this is to kind of socially distance children and other individuals. I also want to say that most of these cases, 80% of them, are mild. And of those cases that become more severe and unfortunately in some rare circumstances can lead to death, that's usually our higher risk population, those who are 60 and older who have other underlying chronic conditions. So I think that we all should be thinking about, if we're ill, that we stay home and we social distance. That includes grandma and grandpa and other individuals. And as you're looking at your community, are there individuals out there that might need you to go to the grocery store for them or drop by the pharmaceutical store so that they don't have to go out right now in public? They may be already social distancing themselves. We really do want to make sure that individuals in our long-term care facilities are protected. And I know you're not here about long-term care facilities, but again, long-term care facilities are a collection of our highest risk population under one roof. So if you're sick, please don't visit. Please call them and tell them why you're not visiting, but please do not do that. And as always, the Indiana State Department of Health will continue to engage anytime that our local health officer, our local school systems, our local school boards reach out, and be there for consultation and assistance. Thank you.